Hi guys, there was a plan to form two IIMs. One was in Calcutta, one was in Mumbai. Now this was going on in 1955. T.T. Krishna Ramachari, the Union Minister of Commerce, announced to the government that we are going to form the campus. Earlier the plan was to make one campus, then they decided to do campus. Because if you look at the India, independent India, the two major cities at that time, see, Delhi was a political capital. So, Calcutta and Mumbai were the industrial hub. And considering the management is basically to train the senior management people. At that time, BBA concept was already there. So, bachelors of administrative work training was already being done through BBA. So, there was a MBA requirement at that time. So, Calcutta and Mumbai was decided that there will be two campuses. Yeah. Mumbai, for some reason, Ahmedabad took over. So the IIM concept went to Ahmedabad. I've talked about that in a separate story. So Mumbai University wanted to have the campus on. Now, if you look at the history of Mumbai University have given India's first BCom college, Sydenham College, India's first BBA college, Wilson College. And of course, they wanted to give to the India the first number one MBA college as well. And that's where they were fully hoping that IIM will start in Mumbai, under Mumbai University, because Mumbai had the rule at that time. Mumbai University was very, very strong, still is very strong. So Mumbai University wanted to control everything. IIT Bombay went out of hand. IIT Bombay went to the centralized were not in the hand of Mumbai University. So they were hell-bent to have a campus there. So this is where the concept of Jawaharlal Bajaj came on board. So they had Stanford on board. Stanford will provide the training to all the faculty members. Faculty member will travel to Stanford for the education, for their training to start the B school in India. Yeah, Jawaharlal Bajaj Foundation. Jawaharlal Bajaj was a philanthropist. After his death, he was a freedom fighter and wrestler. After that, from the Bajaj Group. After his death, the Bajaj Foundation was laid, that they were sponsoring the various colleges and all. So two colleges they sponsored. One was Jawaharlal Bajaj MBA College and one was Janaki Devi Bajaj. It happened way after the death of Mr. Jawaharlal Bajaj. So they donated the money to start the campus. Mumbai University provided the land for the campus and the campus was set up called Jawaharlal Bajaj. Yeah, so because Ahmedabad took away with IIM Ahmedabad, went there. So JBIM is because they wanted a centralized college. They never wanted to have an independent campus like I'm Ahmedabad, I'm Calcutta. So both the sides have their own advantages. Yeah. So Mumbai University started their own campus, which was India's third number campus. And then for a long time, there were only four colleges. I'm Ahmedabad, I'm Bangalore, Jawaharlal Bajaj and FMS College. There were only four colleges. XLRI is considered to be number one college, but for that were labor laws. That were mainly predominantly for the human resources. The management part of XLRI came on board very, very late. Yeah. So Jawaharlal Bajaj, this is how JBIM started. If you do like this video, please do comment because I'm going to make more videos like this. All the best. All right. So let's look at the placement report for Jawaharlal Bajaj. 65 people came, companies came in campus because batch size small, only 120, and 60 PPO was or PPI, mean half of the batch already got placed. Yeah. Highest CTC is 34.36 lakhs. Top 10 of the batch got 33.83 lakhs. Yeah, which is as good as any of the main IIMs, even if in the top 30. So top 30 from the batch. So this means 40 people in Jawaharlal Bajaj will get the same salary of IIM Ahmedabad, IIM Bangalore, IIM Calcutta. Median is 22.84 and mean is 22.84 and median is 22. So with 6 lakh of pack fees, this is one of the best ROI you can get. Yeah, FMS and Jawaharlal Bajaj, both being the departmental campus. Yeah, the ROI is very less. It's very, very good, sorry. So that's the history about Jawaharlal Bajaj. So if you do like this video, please do comment and do like. I'll make more videos like that. So target for you is very simple, to score 140 marks. CMAT, CET, CAT. You need to be a topper in other words. 140 mark is an achievable target kind of thing to look at. Yeah, in case you want to join our program, you can call us on any of these numbers for books, classes, e-classes, mocks, for CAT or CET or any other exams. Numbers, you can call us on any of these numbers given here. Alright, all the best. Thank you.